Good day, another episode of our special documentary of Do Philippines Deserve Me? Our next candidate is Maria Leonor Stowe. Thomas Gerona was born on April 23, 1965, in Naga, Camarines Sur, Philippines. She was the first of three children born to Naga City Regional Trial Court Judge Antonio Gerona, c. 1933-2013, and Salvation Stowe. Thomas, 1936-2020. Leni Gerona attended the Basic Education Department of Universidad de Sta. Isabel in Naga, graduating from elementary school in 1978, and from high school in 1982. She earned her degree in economics from the University of the Philippines Diliman in 1986, and proceeded to study law at the University of Nueva Caceres, graduating in 1992. She passed the bar exams in 1996. Leni was married to Jesse Robredo, whom she met while working at the Baikal River Basin Development Program, from 1987 until his death from a plane crash in 2012. The couple has three daughters, Jessica Marie Aka Robredo, Janine Patricia Trisha Robredo, and Jillian Therese Robredo. Their eldest daughter, Aka, was an executive assistant at the Office of Civil Defense, while their second eldest, Trisha, is a licensed physician and was a UAP basketball sideline reporter for National University. Their youngest, Jillian, is currently studying biomolecular science since May 14, 2017. Robredo hosts her own public service radio program entitled Bizer Bizi Ung Leni, aired on Inspired by the People Power Revolution after graduating from UP Diliman. Gerona chose to temporarily forgo law studies and instead decided to work as a researcher for the Baikal River Basin Development Program, BRBDP, a government agency tasked with integrated area development planning in the three provinces of the Baikal region. Here she met then program director Jesse Robredo, who would eventually become her husband, having passed the bar on her second attempt in 1996 and admitted in May 1997. Robredo served in the public attorney's office, a role in which she often took up the defense for cases pursued by her husband, who by then had become mayor of Naga from 1998 to 2008. Robredo became the coordinator of Centro ng Alternatibong Linggap Panlagan, Salagan, a Naga-based alternative legal support group. Salagan's work aimed to encourage young legal professionals to take on leadership roles and involved visiting distant rural communities to provide legal services to residents who would otherwise have little or no access to such services, as well as conducting legal advocacy by proposing amendments and new laws based on the needs of these marginalized communities. Later, the group's focus shifted to include helping rural women to acquire capital in order to participate in competitive markets. In addition, Robredo founded the Lakas ng Kababaihan ng Naga Federation, an organization that provides training and livelihood opportunities for women. In 1989 and 2012, Robredo was named the chairperson of the Liberal Party in Camarines Sur. On October 5, 2015, after her three daughters set aside their initial objections, Robredo announced that she would run for the post of Vice President of the Philippines under the Liberal Party in the 2016 election. As the running mate of presidential candidate Mar Roxas, Robredo won the election with 14,418,817 votes, or 35.11% of cast ballots, narrowly defeating her closest rival, Senator Bongbong Marcos, by 263,473 votes, or by 0.64%. Robredo was sworn in as Vice President of the Philippines on June 30, 2016, At the Quezon City reception house, which she had since used as her office, Vice President Leni Robredo listed down her accomplishments in the 5 months she has served as the chairperson of the Housing and Urban Development Coordinating Council, HUDC. These include the cutting of red tape, providing low-cost housing for at least 46,000 families, and the start of construction of at least 17,000 homes for victims of Super Typhoon Yolanda. This data was released by her office on Monday, the same day she tendered her resignation as HUDC chairperson. Robredo said that she worked diligently in the short time she served as housing secretary. During the pandemic, the office of the vice president, OVP, under Robredo provided free shuttle services for pandemic frontline workers, swab tests, telehealth services, and raised funds for relief operations across the country. Robredo is the second woman to serve as vice president of the Philippines after Gloria Macapagal Arroyo and the first vice president from Bicol Region. In 2016, Robredo was awarded by the Thai government for her work and advocacy in women empowerment and gender equality under her leadership. The OVP also received the ISO 9001:2015 certification for the office's quality management systems, achievements, projects as Vice President A, Effective and Timely Pandemic Response 1, Vaccination of Drivers in Partnership with Local Governments 2, Distribution of Testing Kits, PPE, Face Masks, and Food Packs on a Daily Basis Since the Pandemic Started 3, Housing Projects 4, Computer Learning Hubs 5, Dormitory for Frontliners and Students 6, Free Transport for Frontliners in Metro Manila and Metro Cebu 7, Community E-Commerce to Assist Public Market Vendors 8, Bienni Consulta B, Social Services to Far-Flung Villages, Laylan, C, Job Training, Trobahope, to out-of-school youth in cooperation with the United States Agency for International Development, USAID, D, Assistance to Community and Micro-Entrepreneurs E, Highest Audit Rating from the Commission on Audit, Co, F, Professionalization of the Office of the Vice President, OVP, with ISO Certification Advocacies, Stand on Issues Pro Transparency or Freedom of Information. She religiously filed her Statement of Assets, Liabilities and Net Worth, SALN, Anti-Political Patronage Pro Anti-Political Dynasty Pro Drug Rehabilitation of Drug Victims Pro Same-Sex Unions. Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. has filed his motion for reconsideration to the Supreme Court's unanimous dismissal of his electoral protest against Vice President Leni Robredo, insisting that elections in three provinces in Mindanao must be annulled because of widespread fraud and terrorism. Marcos appealed the Supreme Court sitting as the Presidential Electoral Tribunal, PET, to proceed with the presentation of evidence for the third cause of action. According to his 96-page motion submitted to the court on Monday, May 10, a copy of which was provided to media in May 11. The SC refused to fully investigate Marcos' claims of fraud and terrorism in Lanao del Sur, Basilan, and Maguindanao, citing Rule 65 of the PET rules that limits the number of pilot provinces to three. Having lost the recount in the initial pilot provinces of Camarines Sur, Iloilo, and Negros Oriental, the SC said Marcos cannot pick a second set of pilot provinces as that violates Rule 65. Vice President Leni Robredo on Thursday filed her Certificate of Candidacy, CoC, as she joined the 2022 presidential derby. The opposition's official bet lodged her CoC at the Harbor Garden tent of Sofitel Hotel in Pasig City. She will be running under the opposition coalition One Sambayan. Roberto said that two of the primary factors she is weighing in before making a decision on a possible presidential run is her desire to stop the Marcoses from returning to power and to prevent another brand of governance similar to President Rodrigo Duterte. Roberto will again face off with Marcos after the latter's loss in the 2016 vice presidential race. Marcos, son of late dictator Ferdinand Marcos and Imelda Marcos, who was convicted of 7 counts of graft, however, claimed that he was cheated and filed a complaint before the Presidential Electoral Tribunal, PET. The Supreme Court, sitting as the PET, however, unanimously dismissed Marcos' poll protest for lack of merit. This has been Leslie Kim Martin.